Afterbeat and Demo. I'm here with David. He is the CEO and chairman of Fusionio, and we're hosting this fabulous party together.
Yes.
And you took the time to debut this fabulous rack with this fabulous technology on stage tonight. Would you tell me a little bit about what that is doing?
So it's showing how to feed data very, very quickly into applications so that you can get more computing done with less servers is really what it boils down to.
That's a very elegant description of what's going on inside that rack.
It's much more complicated on the inside.
But. Oh, I'm sure it is. Without getting too technical, I do love talking about servers and data centers.
Yes.
And I visited one of Facebook's data centers recently and got to tour inside all of their beautiful server rooms and all the stuff. And
it's pretty amazing how big they are.
They're huge, yeah, and they're majestic. It's like looking at the Grand Canyon of computers.
Yeah.
So what I wanted to talk with you about is you guys have made leaps and bounds, to say the least, in server efficiency. And I know that's a problem that Facebook and Google and a lot of other companies that use a lot of data are really focused on.
Correct, yeah.
So what can you tell us about, I know you've worked a little bit with Facebook, what can you tell us about how they're handling data in a different way because of their work with you?
Well, where we are in their infrastructure, they use us in a number of different application areas, but probably the one that is the largest that we're most aware of is their user databases, where all of the interactions that we share on Facebook get recorded. Those databases take up a lot of servers. And what we do for them is we allow them to scale to put more users and more data per user in each server, and therefore reducing the number of servers that they need to address a certain number of total users. I mean, they have 500 million users basically that log in daily.
Yeah.
That's pretty amazing.
Well, I mean, they're growing to the point now that I'm sure sometime within the next couple months, they will have one of every seven people in the world on Facebook. And I mean, when you start talking about human scale like that, you have to wonder what kind of footprint is that making on our environment.
Right.
And do you think that Fusionio's technology is having a measurable impact on our carbon footprint?
Well, I think it's only
starting. Does it have the potential to?
It does have the potential to. I mean, what many of our customers see is that servers are capable of 10 times the workload of what they're generally getting today without the technology.
It's kind of like the human brain. We only use this little bit
only
of
use
it.
One ten. Hey, that, I'm going to have to use that from now on. So, yeah, but if you can tap into that other 90%, right, then that means it takes fewer servers. But here's the counterpoint to that. Let's suppose that it is effective at reducing the cost and power consumption. What that means, though, is that now new businesses that would not have been cost effective, that would not have been feasible because they couldn't build that many data, they couldn't afford the data center they'd need, whatever, those become possible. So in reality, as we lower the cost per unit of useful computing by improving the efficiency, you're broadening the applicability of it. And that doesn't mean you're going to make less of it. It means that more of it is used. But it helps render value in society in very real ways. We live in the information age, and when you look at these computing systems, let us do things that are even more damaging on the environment more effectively. Manufacturing efficiency, just how we do those things are driven by the efficiency in the data center.
That's so tragic. I don't think Werner Herzog could have made something sadder out of such a lovely piece of technology we were looking at
tonight.
No,
but you have to realize that technology is the lesser of the evils when it comes to the industrial revolution and making industrial manufacturing more efficient.
Okay.
And less resources and damage on the environment used there by being smarter about how we use things. And technology allows us to be smarter in that.
Okay. In closing, I would like to ask you, since this is such powerful technology and it has the potential to impact society, Is there any thoughts that you might have about whether or not to open source all or part of what Fusionio is doing?
Having things be open so that people can develop to them is incredibly important, and having a contribution and so forth. There's an interesting challenge, though, with also being able to finance the business and being able to grow the organization. And so striking that balance, I have on staff many major contributors in the open source
world. I'm sure
world.
You do, yeah.
And they allow us to give back and to work together with folks. Over time, everything becomes competitive and moves towards that open model.
Okay, cool. Well, thank you so much for taking
Thanks,
the time
Jolie.
To chat with me. I'm just so rapidly interested in data centers, and I think what you guys are doing is absolutely amazing, and I look forward to hearing more about what you do in the future.
Thanks, Jolie.
Thank you guys for watching. We'll talk to you more soon.